Good evening.
Good evening.
One more time, good evening. Good evening. So I'm your council member, Ben Kallos. It's a pleasure to be here this evening. I want to start by thanking our wonderful sponsors. This wouldn't be happening here on Roosevelt Island without Power Quality and the Roosevelt Island CERT team. You can recognize them because they've got the green hats and the effervescent tops of Power. The CERT team can just stand up and give a quick wave, so let's give them a round of applause for all the great work that they do. This is an event we sponsor every year. Since before I was elected with the Office of Emergency Management, we're joined by Mr. Esposito. If we could just welcome him to Roosevelt Island. Just so you know, once you get the bags are not empty, they've got all sorts of things in them, you will learn about what needs to go inside. So I want to just thank everyone for RSVPing and joining us this evening. So I'm your council member. I represent Roosevelt Island in the east side, east midtown, east Harlem, about 168,000 people, and we're by the river. We're in flood zones. Parts of this district, including and especially Roosevelt Island, flooded during Sandy. And that's why we've been paying a lot of attention during Emergency Preparedness Month. And it's September 29th, just about the end. And if you were paying attention during Hurricane Hermine, this is hurricane season, and that's why we want to get ready for it. And so each year we do this, and you'll learn more about why go-bags are important. But I think a lot of you have started to get used to knowing about our community emergency response team and how active they are, especially looking forward to working with them and seeing them all around on Halloween here on Roosevelt Island. It's always a great time here. So one of the things we wanted to do was make sure you know what the CERT team is, understand how important the work that they do is, so you can say thank you to them for being there to take care of you whenever there's an emergency. And also, if you're interested in joining. So we've got Howard Colley, who leads the CERT here on Roosevelt Island. He's going to take a couple of minutes to talk to you about what they do and how you can join and when the next training is. Please join me in welcoming Howard.
Good evening. Glad to see you full house here. New York City residents enjoy the best emergency services for responders in the nation. We've seen that, unfortunately, at recent events. We've seen quick response, and we owe gratitude to all of them. In addition, on Roosevelt Island, we have public safety, and for large events, such as Sandy, we also enjoy the abilities and efforts of our ground support, who keep the island in good shape, keep us safe. Now, New York City has a lot of professional first responders, but we also have the need for people in the neighborhood who can help out their neighbors, people who can help their neighbors prepare for emergencies, people who augment and aid the first responders when they're in the neighborhood. We know the neighborhood, police, fire come in, they need help helping people who need help. 13 is available to prepare the community for events, to aid the first responders during the event, and then also help the community after the event. People have learned that after events, communities need time to recover. So what the CERT team does is build resiliency in the neighborhood. This is a very important role, and I'm glad to have a CERT team here on Roosevelt Island. I hope you get some interest in joining the training. CERT members are volunteers who take a 10 or 11 week training course that covers basics, elements of all the operations, the fire and police, so that they know, we know one or two things to help them. They can direct us, and we augment what they do. The next training, I believe, is in November, and I think it's mostly subscribed. If we get enough effort, we will try to have another training here. This is unusual, but we've had two trainings right on the island in the last one about 2 years ago. So I'm so pleased to see everyone here. One thing that you can do that will help you with an emergency is pay attention and be aware of your neighbors. If you see something going on, say something. If you're concerned about the weather, concerned about some other event, we are public safety department, are a great resource for the community. They provide information. We are has an alert system that you can subscribe to that will reach you by text, by phone, by email, and you'll be aware of what's going on in time to prepare. So I'd like to turn this over now to New York Emergency Management Commissioner. And again, we have a table in the back. Please sign up if you're interested. We'll get some literature to you and try to work through the system. Thanks again.
Thank you to Howard and our research team. Next up, we'll hear from Susan Rosenthal, our president here at the Roosevelt Hockery Corporation, as well as Jack. Please welcome.
Very detailed mappings of Roosevelt Island, which all were inputted in this sophisticated software at the 911 call center. Howard joined us, and we took a tour of the upgrades to the system. And frankly, I have to tell you, I was shocked at how quickly they had responded to our concerns. We walked around the call center and saw computer screens, large computer screens highlighting Roosevelt Island and the distinct unique nature of the island. We learned about a new system where if someone calls, and this is important, everyone should know that if you call 911, just say Roosevelt Island. Now Roosevelt Island, you say it, pops up almost as if it's a unique, separate borough. And then it immediately, if you need help of emergency aid, it immediately goes to the Queens North unit for an ambulance. So this is all, I think, an incredible response to our outcry. So I'd like to thank the commissioner and all of the different agencies that participated in that. Jack, you want to introduce our deputy?
One other thing to add to what Susan was saying. One of the issues, as we moved and quickly got into the 911 issue, was the issue of cross streets. And There are no questions on Roosevelt Island. There are monitors all over the 911 call center, all of the operators. All of these, and they run like some current information. And one of the things that they scroll through is Roosevelt Island, no cross streets. So the response from OEM and the police department, fire department was incredible. So at this time, I wanted to introduce Kevin Brown. Kevin Brown is the new deputy director for public safety. He spent 32 years in the police department. Just retired recently. And I'm just going to give the mic to him so he can say a few words.
Good evening. I'm very happy to be here. Manny says, my name is Kevin Brown. I'm the new deputy director of public safety at Roosevelt Island. What's the most important thing is that the first day that I took this job is that Ms. Roosevelt told me that she wants me to work on a comprehensive plan to be prepared in times of emergency. So that's what we're doing, that's what we're focusing our attention on, is that we will have a plan for all of the residents on Roosevelt Island in case of any type of emergency, that we can be prepared to serve all of the residents here. And our number one concern is our safety with the residents here. Now we'll be working on that plan and getting it out to you so that we can all be prepared and be safe.
One final comment. I want to thank the commissioner for taking our concerns about our bridge. And we all know how to speak with our bridge. And we reached out to the OEM and the Coast Guard.
Because we don't want to have a health and safety risk. The only one bridge, we only access for needed particular traffic. The OEM is taking our cries seriously, and we're going to sit around a table with all of the interested parties to make sure that this doesn't happen again, and if it does, have a plan that works more efficiently and expeditiously. So thank you, Commissioner.
As well as law enforcement. Before taking the post at OEM, the commissioner was the chief of department for the NYPD. And I happened to be at one time during my career his executive office. So with that, I'd like to introduce Commissioner Esposito, who is a friend and a mentor and always there to move it up on the request help.
Okay, I want to thank the councilman and everyone else who organized this event. I've done a few of these events with the council member, and it's very important that people are prepared. And this is the go bag and the plans that we have for you tonight will help you be prepared. Kevin, welcome aboard. Susan, Jack, Howard, thank you for your support. You know, Roosevelt Island, this is one big family, basically. We've all got to work together to the best of the time. Thank you, and again, thank you for this opportunity tonight. Be prepared is what it's all about. If you look at the things that have happened around the city recently, Hurricane Hermine, we dodged that bullet recently. We are now monitoring Hurricane Matthew. We just declared a hurricane today. Is that right, Ben? Today we declared a hurricane. We're monitoring that. If some of the folks that monitor these things say has a chance of coming up the coast, so we're monitoring that very, very closely. But those are what we call planned events. Those are things that we can get ready for in time. Usually if a hurricane is coming, we have a few days' notice. So we'll be able to warn the public where we think it's coming, if you have to evacuate, how you would evacuate, what zone you have to evacuate. I think Roosevelt Island is the most of the islands in zone 3, which is right in the middle of. We have 6 zones, right in zone 3. So we would let you know ahead of time if you had to evacuate, and we could prepare for that. But many times things happen that we aren't prepared for. The bombing in Chelsea a couple of weeks ago, the bombing in the Bronx the other day, when unfortunately took the life of that firefighter. The train crash today in Jersey. These are things that happen on the spur of the moment. That's why it's so important to have a plan. And you see these pamphlets here, how to be ready. Everyone should take one of these here, fill it out, and have a plan for you, your family, and your loved ones. It'll tell you what to do. This way you can say to yourself, if something does happen, you can say, I have a plan, I know what to do, instead of, what do I do? You want to know what to do when something happens. That's why he's going so important. And Councilman, thank you so much for the money to buy his money from his stipends to help pay for these bags so that everyone can have it. We don't have to go. And let me tell you why GoBank is important. Again, you have a planned event like a hurricane that's coming. Well, okay, you have time to sit down and think, all right, what do I have to do? Where am I going to go? What do I have to take with me? But if something were to happen, unfortunately, like an explosion, where you've got to get out of your house in a moment's notice, you wouldn't have time to look for certain things, to make a plan to bring things with you. That's why this go bag is so important. You put this by the door, you have things that you will need to sustain yourself for the next few hours at least. An extra pair of glasses, an extra key to the car, let's say, a flashlight, maybe a snack, some of your medication. You know, you're going to be running out that door. You want to be able to grab this bag and go and know that you could be out of your house, out of your element for a day or so and say, you know what, I have enough here for my essentials that will get me through the day. Also, your plan will be there. This way, in case you're separated from a loved one, part of the plan is know where to go. If we get separated, something happens, you know, go to Grandma's house, go to Uncle Jimmy's house, go to Aunt Lily's house. They're all the way to go, and you can't get a hold of one another if there's no cell service. Again, in that go bag, you have a charging device, let's say, for your phone, or an extra battery, to take an extra battery. So you personalize that go bag to what you need. And again, this pamphlet and these go bags will tell you how to be ready. It's very, very important. So again, I want to thank you all for being out here today. Also, Ready New York City, this plan. Also, we have Notify NYC, especially being here in Roosevelt Island. Notify NYC is a program that we have, that we manage here in emergency management. To hack your phone, it'll actually go to your home phone, and you go zero in, you, let's say you live, it's all live in Roosevelt Island, you punch in this area, you'll get alerts on your devices if there's a train delay, if the train is out of order, if there's a water leak, if there's a power outage. It'll tell you what's going on, up to date, real time, on what's going on the island. You can also punch in, I think it's up to five locations you can punch in. So if you live on the island, but let's say you work down in Lower Manhattan, you can punch in Lower Manhattan, and what it'll tell you is it's a train delay. There's something going on, it'll tell you all the events that have gone around the city, so up to five locations. If you live on Roosevelt, if you work downtown Manhattan, but you have a family member that maybe goes to school in Midtown, punch in Midtown. You'll get up-to-date information on what's going on in the areas that concern you. So very, very important. Notify NYC. You can go to nyc.gov and sign up for 311 and sign up, or you can follow us on Twitter. It takes all of 2 minutes to sign up for this, and I really strongly suggest this all happens. I really, really do. I know we have some issues here on the island. And that's what we're here to talk about. I know we're concerned about evacuating this island. I think you have a plan. I don't think all of you are satisfied with that plan, as many of you like to be. My commitment to you tonight is we are going to sit with Jack and his team. We will sit starting tomorrow. We are going to put a team together. Leadership, his shop, my shop. We will talk about what the best way to evacuate this island would be, if in fact we had to do that, either planned or unplanned. But again, if a hurricane came, we usually give 2 days' notice for evacuation. That's plenty of time to get off the island if we had to. What I'm more concerned about is if something happened and we need an immediate evacuation for this island, I think it would be important to make sure that the folks in this room, all the residents on this island, are comfortable with the plan that we get as have in a timely fashion. So Jack, we'll sit tomorrow about that. Jack, we'll sit, put a team together. And I need membership from your island, because what I find is the people who have the best answers to the problem are the people that are closest to the problem. So the people in this room are closest to the problem. So we're going to need some people from the Roosevelt Island Association to sit with us and help us put the plan together. So I want to thank you all for coming out tonight. This is a great first step on being prepared. I urge you, fill out the pamphlets, get a go bag, make sure it's personalized to your own needs, to what you need. And again, it's better to have a plan. When that thing happens, you're saying, I know what to do, instead of, what do I do? So please, pay attention, walk my coaching back, take these flyers, and enjoy your day. All right? I think we're going to open it up for questions in a little while. I think Christine, you want to talk about it?
Have everything you need so that you can grab an end.
grab it, you. Go. So you're going to have your grab and? And it'll have everything you need. So by this point, I think a couple of people had questions, and I'm hoping that my staff can bring it up to me, with a couple of questions that we got from the community. And then after that, what we're going to do is we're going to call you up by the number that you checked in, just like on an airplane. Do we have any question cards back? Raise your hands if you have cards that have questions. I'm not seeing any. Does anyone just have a question? Okay, I see three questions. You fill out your cards. So let me just take those cards. Okay, we have it. Give us one moment, sorry. We'll just bring it up. Can we please bring the three cards up so we can answer the questions? So our first question is, how about our pets in case of an emergency? I have an adopted cat named Pandora, and after a birth did not work. And I would like to know what to do about my cat.
Okay, after Sandy, we realized a lot of people didn't evacuate because they were worried about their pets. Believe it or not, they wouldn't leave their pets concerned. We have a storehouse in Jersey. We have a storehouse in Long Island. We have a storehouse in Brooklyn. We have enough products in those warehouses to supply 70,000 people for 7 days. After Sandy, we realized we had to amend what we had in those warehouses. That when we go to a shelter, your needs are met. We go to a shelter, your needs are met. We have supplies for pets. Food, leashes, cages, whatever you need. We have, and believe it or not, we have supplies for dogs, cats, snakes, all different types of things. Live in the city, you know how many people have exotic pets. You know that. Anybody have an exotic pet? No? Good, I'm glad. But you do, okay. But the bottom line is, we have supplies in our warehouse. And if you will go to a shelter, we can supply the needs of you, your family, your friends, your children, and your pets. Jack, the question is, you say Roosevelt or Roosevelt? That's the question. What's the proper word? You say potato, I say tomato. I don't think it matters how much, right?
So the second question, this is a new New Yorker. They wrote, what do you do if you just moved to New York and have zero family around? Where do you go? Who do you go to in an emergency? So as the commissioner said, this community and others are an extended family. We encourage people, if you don't have family around, to make connections with your neighbors, with friends, so you can help them and they can help you. But if something happens, if, like the commissioner said, there's either a planned event, like a hurricane or something, or if there's an unplanned event, like say there was some type of explosion and we have to get people off the island, generally what we do when we open shelters are we go to schools, because, you know, they're open, we have an agreement, they're safe, they're clean, they have food. So we would come, we would work with Rio, PD, Fire, everyone, to evacuate people. If people wanted to, we would ask them to go to the school. And like the commissioner said, we'll assist you with your needs. We have medical supplies, we have different dietary foods, we have clothes, we have things for children. So, you know, we encourage people, we think people will be more comfortable if something happens, being able to evacuate to family or friends. But if that's not possible, we certainly have a place. If it's something more small, like if there's a fire or something in just your apartment or your building is affected, usually what we do is we work with the Red Cross, and the Red Cross has an agreement with hotels in the city. And so if it's something smaller, like 5 or 10 people, we'll put people up in hotels while they make their way through the emergency. If it's something larger, like a few buildings, or a block, we usually will open schools or other types of shelters.
Okay, we have one here about the evacuation plan and sheltering, which is very, very important. Now, talking about shelters, we can't have a shelter on the island. Obvious reasons, you're in a flood zone, you're in an evacuation zone. We can't shelter you in a school or a library or an auditorium if it's going to flood. So we're going to evacuate. And again, evacuation zone 3, it changes going to flood, so we can't have it on the island. So we have school as outside the flood zone that you would be designated to go to. That's the way it would work. Now, what we would do is, once the flood is over, this is a hurricane. If there's a hurricane, then flood. Once the water recedes, we would open up shelters on the island once the water is receding for services. Again, those commodities I talked about, 70,000 people for 7 days, we would open a commodity distribution point on the island, a service center on the island. This way, the folks who live here can get back to normal as soon as possible. So, sheltering, you have to go off the island. Services, we come to the island. As far as evacuation, yes, we would plot the evacuation plan as a bridge, a tram, the train, buses, deliveries, all means of transportation possible. Again, I don't have in-depth knowledge about the evacuation plan for the island. Starting tomorrow, we're going to look at the plan. I know a lot of the folks in this room have questions and concerns about the evacuation plan. Based on that, we'll form that group starting tomorrow. We'll go through the plan, and we'll make sure that the residents here in town are happy with their evacuation.
Mr. Chairman, we have three questions about persons with disabilities, what to do if you're a caretaker, what to do if you're disabled, and what to do about elevators, air emergencies.
Okay, people with disabilities. Our shelters are capable of handling people with disabilities. We have a number of them around the city. We have inspectors that go out. Look at them. We have over 100 shelters in the city. And we're in the process of making as many of those shelters as possible to be accessible for people with disabilities. So we're actively doing that. We'll have probably by this time next year, we'll have over 100 of our shelters that will be able to handle people with disabilities. So we're very, very concerned about that. And that's something that came to light at this in the office of one of the things that came about. Special needs, those shelters, there's special medical needs shelters. We have special shelters for people with medical needs. So we do address that also. Again, after Sandy, we come up with 14 or 15 playbooks that we address the needs that we discovered after Sandy. We're in much better shape. This city is in much better shape after Sandy to deal with a crisis like Superstorm Sandy. But again, disabilities in the front of my mind, the centers are becoming more and more accessible, and special medical needs are quickly happening in place.
So it's around 7 o'clock, we've gotten streaming cards. So in the next moment or two, if you could please write down your final question so we can get to everyone and try to start getting people their go backs. So we've got more questions.
I know from previous